Hello and welcome to my channel Spark Stenographer. Today I am going to deliver you a shorthand dictation from Kailash Chandra magazine volume number 2 and the transcription number 37. So guys, ready for the dictation? 10 seconds, 5 seconds. Start. Madam Deputy Chairman, I rise to participate in this discussion not with a view to ventilate particular grievances or to secure concessions and relief in the taxation measures. I am one of those who believe that there is no justification for additional taxation unless the conditions laid down by the Taxation Inquiry Commission are complied with. It was a commission presided over by no less a person than Mr. John Mehta, one of our illustrious finance ministers, and it laid down that there was no justification for any additional taxation unless we complied with two or three conditions. One condition was that whatever tax was released was being properly spent, that there was no wastage or superfluous expenditure being incurred. The commission had pointed out that out of every rupee that was being raised by the government, 60 paisa were being spent on administration and about 20 paisa were being spent on social services including education, etc., and the balance for other things. Another was that whatever tax was being imposed should be realized before we brought out measures for fresh taxation. They also had suggested that there was sufficient room for economy in all the ministries and departments and effective steps should be taken forthwith to enforce the maximum possible economy in government expenditure. Now we have before us this audit report for 2011 to 2012, which was represented to the Lok Sabha on the 6th June and which came to my hands last night. I have not been able to study it. I find that during the last 5 years, we have imposed additional taxation and at the same time our revenue expenditure has gone up by rupees 42 crores. So, on the one hand, we say that we are raising this money, these taxes, for the implementation of the plan. And for that reason, every chief minister and ministers go about saying that we want money for the implementations to the plan. But what are the facts? We find the money that has been raised is being used for administrative purposes. So it is not correct to say that. On the other hand, it is not proper because you must know that no plan, however well balanced and well thought out it may be, can be implemented in a democratic setup unless you can enthuse the people. We have been depending either on foreign aid or on indirect taxation or deficit financing, and more than once I have pointed out that these measures will not help to enthuse the people, and unless the people are enthused, we will not have any successful results so far as planning is concerned. Now it is necessary. It is time that we should take stock of the situation, for we have had 54 years of freedom and 52 years of democratic rule and of planned economy. What are the results? I am not one of those who minimize our achievements. We have had some achievements which are remarkable, of which we can be proud. We have had 3 general elections and we can be proud of all this. But it is equally true that the expectations of the people remain mostly unfulfilled. They remain unrealized. What are the expectations of the people? They wanted an adequate supply of drinking water. They wanted a little more wholesome food in their stomachs, a little more clothes on their bodies, a stronger roof over their heads, freedom from the clutches of the corrupt officials and the grumbling intermediaries, and speedier justice. But what have we done? Have we been able to satisfy those expectations? I can say no. Even the 11th five-year plan, we find that all the villages have not been provided with adequate supply of drinking water. And as for food, only the other day the finance minister himself admitted in the other house that there was adulteration of foodstuffs all round. Not only that, a former health minister admitted in this house that it was difficult to get any article of food unadulterated, then what is the use of talking about pure food articles and of other health facilities when the people are going articles which are as good as poison. They are injurious to health. The other day, the finance minister is reported to have said that the taxation proposals did not affect the common man because he needed only a course with cloth and ordinary food. During the last 5 years, we have raised rupees 424 crores more. Including the taxation measures, this year the increase in revenue will be about 75%. Since 2006, we have raised additional taxation to the tune of 75%, and during the 5 years preceding this year's, the revenue expenditure has gone up by 85%. I would like to know how much of this amount has gone towards developmental expenditure and towards social support.